How's everybody doing?
Good evening, good evening.
Sixty Oak Street. You guys know why I'm here, you know, Union President, Montgomery Fire Department. We had an issue a few weeks ago with the mayor abruptly canceling five. Did he say four in the media? It was five. Five probationary firefighters for the city of Montgomery, five, okay? Now, if he said, what he said was he wanted the new mayor to take care of that. So if that's the case, he should let the new mayor take care of Oscar Davis with that money. Our issue is simple. You know, you have to hire more firefighters. The hardest thing for a firefighter to deal with is the emotional effect of dealing with people's destruction, pumping 2-year-old baby's chest, watching people burn, and just all the destruction that we constantly deal with. That's a psychological beatdown that some of you don't understand and don't realize. Yet they say firefighters don't do a lot. That's a bunch of BS. We do a hell of a lot. And a lot of it you don't see. You know, that when we took that kid out of the elevator in your building, okay, the kid was all punctured up. We out there on car accidents. Our rescue right now is being held hostage because the city won't pay the $20,000 it needs to pay for another fire engine that was fixed here. But again, Oscar Davis gets his money. Okay? That's your rescue. That rescue can keep you guys safe. The equipment that we have in that rescue is something that we need every day in this city. The Bronx River, the Hudson River Parkway, all those highways that connect to this city is something that we patrol every day to keep people safe. Now, in terms of moving forward, you know, we did something that was unprecedented in this primary. We attacked the mayor because he deserved to be attacked.
Yes.
Okay?
Amen.
He deserved what he got from us. Now, we know that there are seats on the council in 2 years that's coming up. We never get involved in council races, but we will if we have to. We will be on you like we were on him to make the changes that is needed in this city. These jobs is the people job. They put you here to protect them, not to protect their best interests. And I think that this city has become a cesspool of dirty politics.
Yes.
That's right. Tell them, bro.
You know, I grew up with Ricky Thomas, and we supported him, and we've had a lot of conversations over the past few weeks. And you know, just all of the stuff that's going on in the city, it just seems like they're trying to financially destroy this city before this man gets a chance to make a change in the city.
That's right.
With that being said, Richie, fire department is behind you all the way. So whatever it is you need, we're going to be there for you 1,000%. No disrespect to you, Deborah, but this is business. We chose to come in, okay? And that's who we chose, and that's who we're going to support. And whatever it is that we have to do to get you over the top, we're going to do that. And Marcus, I'm still waiting for that phone call you're supposed to give me 2 weeks ago. Thank you.
Yes, it is.